gathered together, number 698.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with
your spirit. Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you. And thank each and every one of you. We have come before God with joy. We bring our needs, our joys. We bring ourselves before God. As in this Mass, we are requested to pray for
the repose of the soul of George Fishers, Alvarez Resendez, and Joe Beth Sherrod.
And we continue to pray for Vincent and Maria, and for Peter, for Joseph. We ask God in His mercy to come to our aid as we bring each and every one of you, your families, your intentions before God. Asking that in His mercy, He will hear us and grant our heart's desires through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, we are sinners and in need of God's grace. Let us therefore take a moment to recall the times we have failed God and man. Be sorry for those times as we ask God for His pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, You raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You feed us with Your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May the Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose providence never fails in His design, keep from us, we humbly beseech You, all that might harm us, and grant all that works for our good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Proclamation from the second letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, may grace and peace be yours in abundance through knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. His divine power has bestowed on us everything that makes for life and devotion through the knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and power. Through these He has bestowed on us the precious and very great promises, so that through Him, through them, you may come to share in the divine nature, after escaping from the corruption that is in the world because of evil desire. For this very reason, make every effort to supplement your faith with virtue, virtue with knowledge, knowledge with self-control, self-control with endurance, endurance with devotion, devotion with mutual affection with love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. In You, my God, I place my trust.
In You, my God, I place my trust.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. In you, my God, I place my trust. Because he clings to me, I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he acknowledges my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in distress.
In you, my God, I place my trust.
I will deliver him and glorify him. With length of days I will gratify him and will show him my salvation.
In you, my God, I place my trust.
Please stand. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Theological books, philosophical books, you know. Whether you are reading them or not, it doesn't concern anybody. But you want people to enter your room and see a collection of books. But then, there was this guy, you know. He didn't like buying books. And he would always keep his money. But he had the largest library in his room. He never bought any book. He will come to you and borrow your book. He will not go to the library to borrow. He will come to you, borrow your book, go to his room and put put it in his library. He will go to another person, borrow a book, go to his room, put it in his library. And his library was growing, you know, growing and growing, and people will come, "Well, Joe, you're buying books." He said, "You guys don't know what I'm doing. I'm buying. I'm not wasting my time." Until after a time, it was discovered that he would go and borrow books from people, go and put it in his library, and he would never return it. And then one day we ask, "What are you doing with your money?" He said, "Well, I'm saving it for ordination." He was saving his money for ordination. That was the image that came to me when I went through this gospel. The Lord leased out the land to the tenants, and they refused to return the land or the benefit of the land. You know, there are people in life that when you give them anything, it is difficult for them to return it to you. When I was in South Sudan, I was having a discussion one day with the late bishop, but he's so rest in peace. And he was telling me, "You know, I have lost everything in my possession." I said, "My Lord, why?" He said, "You know, people come in here and they borrow and they don't return. So 1 month I took my time to label all my books and properties. I wrote on them, Bishop Akio, please return to where you collected it from." And all these things. But you see, this is the greediness of the human person. Now we like to get, we like to receive, but we don't like to take back to the owner. We do not want to return. This shows the tendency of the human person, not just to hoard, but the wickedness of the heart. Because if we take and we do not return, obviously we are depriving another person of the benefit of using the same. You get what I mean? That is the way it is generally with life. And today the Lord tells us that he has created the world and he has put us in there. Remember, the owner of the vineyard planted the vineyard himself, cultivated it, fenced it, put everything wonderful, and it involved the tenants. Go in and live there. You have nothing to do. Enjoy. But just make sure that at every harvest season, you give me some produce. Not from what you have planted, but from what I, the Lord, planted. You did not plant. Go and enjoy, but give me some proceeds. That was where the problem was. God has planted us in the world, and he has given us everything. Yesterday we had enough rain, and we thank God. He gives us oxygen. He gives us daylight. He gives us initiative. He gives us health. He gives us the ability to talk, to communicate, to work, to do a whole lot of things. But then how grateful are we to God for this? God is not asking us to sacrifice ourselves. No. He has paid the ultimate sacrifice. But are you thankful for that ultimate sacrifice? How grateful are you to God with your life, by your actions? How often do you pray in thanksgiving to God? The Lord reminded the Pharisees and the scribes and the hypocrites today. He has sent us prophets, we killed. He sent us everyone to bring us the good news, asking for the produce of the work of his hands, we have refused. He even sent his son. We gave him disgrace on the cross. What else shall he do? And the Lord, the Jesus said, what will the owner of the vineyard do? He will get those tenants, he will destroy them, and he will lease the land to those who are willing. Are you willing to give back to God? And what are you willing to give him back? God doesn't want our destruction. No. The word of God says, Ezekiel reminds us, I think Ezekiel 18, he says, look, the Lord does not delight in the death of the wicked man. Rather, let him turn from his evil ways and he will live. God wants us to turn. He wants us to have a change of heart. He wants us to have a proper reflection at all times and in everything we do. Are you reflecting about your life? What do you have to give God? The psalmist says, the cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. We pray, my brothers and sisters, that we become reflective every day of our lives. We do inward reflection. We do meditation. We always ask ourselves, the Lord expects something from me. Am I giving it to him? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We will rise and enjoy and hope. Bring our needs to our loving Father in union with our joys.
Let the members of the church find renewed strength in God's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let all nations and peoples find lasting peace in God's plan for this world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we nurture vocations for our families in the priesthood and the religious life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the ill and infirm find abundant comfort in God's healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who worship here find sure hope in God's promises. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying and those who have died find everlasting joy in God's salvation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God our Father, in your mercy, help us hear our prayers, come to our aid. Be with those who have asked that we remember them at masses and prayers. Bless and bring healing to our sick brothers and sisters. Bring restoration, Lord, to the families that are broken. And may your love, your peace reign in our hearts. Hear us, O Lord, more than we can ever ask for, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, may become for us our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. May it become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with a humble and a contrite heart. May the Lord wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from all my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our Creator and all the Holy Church.
Amen. Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to your sacred altar, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be blessed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In him, you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore, he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him, he has become the source of eternal salvation. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Charles, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Saints, St. Paul, St. Patrick, St. Francis, St. Peter, St. Augustine, St. Anthony, St. Christopher, St. Silas, St. Timothy, St. Elizabeth, St. Veronica, St. Cecilia, St. Anne Bobre, St. Josephine Paquita, St. Rose, St. Monica, St. Martha, St. Agnes, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glory invite you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Joy in our hearts. Let us call God Father in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us share a sign of peace with each other.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. sins of the world. Grant us peace.
My brothers and sisters, behold Jesus Christ. Behold him, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter
under
my roof, but
only say
the word, my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life. Amen, I say to you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe you will receive it, and it will be yours, says the Lord. Let us pray. Governed by your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, those you feed with the body and blood of your Son, that professing you, not just in word or in speech, but also in works and in truth, we may merit to enter the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have a great day and a blessed week.
You too, Father.
Please join us as we have our closing.
just a quick announcement, impromptu. Yesterday when Father made the announcements about the Feast of the Sacred Heart that we've never celebrated here, some of us came to him and said, you know, why not? We've put together celebrations before in no time. So we're looking for some volunteers. And I know yesterday I was able to listen to a few of his announcements. And the one from last night, last night's Mass, really, really got to me. In fact, I had to hold back tears because he said he really wanted to celebrate the Sacred Heart of Jesus feast day with the appointment of our pastor. And that hasn't happened yet. So believe me, Father, when that day happens, he'll be dancing in the streets. But anyway, but for now, we're wanting to have a celebration here on Sunday after the Spanish Mass. And so we're looking for some volunteers to help with food. It will be potluck this year. Next year, he wants to have a hoedown, you know, with games for the kids and even games for the adults and music and dancing. So, but for this year, we'll keep it simple. We'll do it the Crosby way, and we'll do it quick. So if anybody can help us put this together for this Sunday, June the 10th. Next year will be the Feast of Sacred Heart is June the 28th, which is a Friday. But I'm guessing that we'll have the feast celebration on Sunday. So let's put that on our calendar so that we can put a committee together for next year and celebrate the patron of our parish and in a big way, okay? So if anybody can help, I sent out some messages last night, but I wasn't allowed to send out too many. And for those that don't have cell phones in particular, I was not able to contact that way. So if anybody is able to help, please let me know. I'm also going to put it on the church Facebook page as an event. So if anyone's on Facebook and can respond that way, that'd be great also, so we can keep in contact. Thank you.
Verse number 2, we gather together in our closing hymn.